dark persona of a rabbit is here in attendance at Tuneries this evening. And tonight is most apt, as it's one of his favorite times of the year here on All Hallows Eve. Deranged rabbit drapes himself over the ropes. Certainly hasn't been making many friends here at Almost Pro. Turning on his former tag team partner and best friend, Fracture the Clown. The smallest graduate of the Almost Pro Wrestling Academy, Lil Smash. The lad who Rabbit ripped the face mask from. The lad whose dreams he destroyed by turning on him. They say you should never meet your heroes. Well, Lil Smash's hero turned on him. And then a low kick, which is the only sort of kick that Lil Smash can do. Well, to be fair to him, he did epically well in the Shieldiversary Rumble, and he's asked for this match. And I'll tell you what, our general manager, Adam Christ, has granted it to him. Oh, and look at this with Cossack kicks from Lil Smash, getting Rabbit to his knees, which is a brilliant strategy because now he's just coming off the ropes and just laying into him. Rabbit and Lil Smash have actually had a tumultuous year with all of the ins and outs and the goings on that's happened with the Weird and the Wonderful, with Rabbit being influenced by Victor von Valtz, Shield Pro Wrestling Champion. And oh, look at that flying head scissors from the diminutive Lil Smash, and Rabbit is reeling. Rabbit lining up. Oh no, he's just been taken out by a dive through the ropes from Lil Smash, who is really taking it to a guy who has humiliated him at every turn throughout the year. But this time, oh! Certainly there is no compassion from Rabbit as he just reversed that Irish whip and just launched the much smaller Smash straight into that ring post, dragging him to his feet, throwing him onto a chair before throwing him back into the ring. And Rabbit is deranged. I mean, I understand why Lil Smash wants to get his hands on him, but he's asking for trouble here. Rabbit's certainly by far more experienced, taller, and has all of the advantages that brings. And he knows how to cheat and get away with it, as he's showing there. Oh, bet that Lil Smash wishes he was out trick-or-treating rather than suffering all of this right now. Oh! He just whips Lil Smash into the corner, comes charging in. Alters himself in that unpredictable style to just lower himself and make sure that that blow had full effect. And now just chokes him in the corner before dragging him out. But Lil Smash fighting back as best he can before a huge clubbing. A clubbing from Rabbit just puts him right back down and goes for the cover, but it's only a two count. And now look at Rabbit just laying the punches in the Lil Smash, and now Singley's going to charge him into the corner, but oh, Lil Smash puts up an elbow just high enough to catch Rabbit, and now drops down. What's he going for? Oh, another drop kick into the ankle, then one to the head. Oh my word. And a very close two count. Smash getting the fans behind him. Pushed into the ropes by Rabbit, and this time it's Rabbit with a back elbow, and he goes for the cover. A very cocky cover it is too, and now he's just laying into the ribs of his former friend and driving his elbow across the face, which is very painful, and doing it whilst you're covering the lad just adds that extra distraction, but not enough to get him. But he maybe wish he has. He's up in the air right now and slammed down from a great height. Dropping the knee on the prone Lil Smash as the referee goes to count, but again, only two. Now Lil Smash thrown to the outside. And Rabbit goes out, wants to inflict more punishment onto the young lad. Now he's just laying in the boots, and hold on a second, is that, oh, he's just been whipped into his parents. How heinous is that? I have never seen anything more heinous on a wrestling show. And they know to just that they can't get involved. They could cost Lil Smash this match if they did. Oh, well, I'll tell you what, he wants to show exactly what he's learned at the Almost Pro School as he just launches in an attack there, but it's not enough to keep Rabbit down as he rolls back into the ring. Oh, and I hope that's what the army uses for doing his homework. Manages to kick out. This is really smart. He's staying on his front. He can't be pinned if he's on his front, but it does leave him a little bit exposed. It's now Rabbit whips Lil Smash into the corner, comes charging in. Oh, but Smash moves out of the way. Comes, oh, he's going up to the middle rope, getting some height. Clocks Rabbit. Spinning DDT from the middle rope, and Rabbit is down. Is this enough? Hooks both legs. Kick out by Rabbit. Slash now encouraging the fans to get behind him, but he's just suffered a little kick there. Oh! As is the referee, Smash moved out the way, wasn't aware the referee was behind him, and the referee goes down, and now DDT on the young academy graduate, and Rabbit goes for the pin, and he could count to 20 right now if he could. But he's kicked the referee in the face, the referee is down. Manages to bring him around, and he's dragging Smash to his feet. Oh, I know what this is. Looks as though he's going to set him up for possibly the eat defeat, but oh, Fracture's come out. The former tag team partner of Rabbit. And Fracture. friend, trainer, and stablemate of Lil Smash. And that distraction's all he needed. A victory against Rabbit here at almost Halloween for the face-painted Lil Smash. And he will be so pleased about this that he's managed to get one over on the guy who has not only let him down but stabbed him in the back and humiliated him throughout the year. As Fracture stands above him, raising his arm, incredibly proud. Stunner. Oh, we know that music. That is our champion, Victor Von Valtz. And I'm going straight after Fracture, the man he actually took the title from at the very first Shieldiversary. Oh! Got to the outside, Fracture flies out and takes out their champion on the floor. Unfinished business with these guys. As some claim, although it's unsubstantiated yet, that Victor Von Valtz has used some sort of hypnotism on Rabbit, which has induced his current state. But right now, this is just a brutal beating between Von Valtz, our champion, and the former champ, Fracture the Clown. Vicious ventriloquist turned hypnotist of hate. Fracture fighting back. This is all amongst the crowd right now. And maybe get it away from the small child. Oh, no. No, he can't pile drive him. Not on a wood floor. He's going for it. No! Fracture saves himself with a massive backdrop. Kick to the ribs. There's Lil Smash still out there looking on. Well, one hero abandoned him. But Fracture hasn't. And Rabbit's still outside as well. I mean, this isn't even official. Oh! Rabbit grabbing the leg of Fracture, who just kicks him off, but it's enough of a distraction for Von Valtz to knock him back to the outside. And Rabbit and Smash getting into it out there as well. This has just turned into absolute chaos and anarchy out there. Photographers are quick to get out of the way. The gallant Kev Ho getting straight out of the way and putting Fallon in harm's way, I think, as action comes back to the ring and Von Valtz standing tall. Oh, look at Von Valtz. Nothing but hate and disgust in the eyes of our champion who has been champion now, ladies and gentlemen, for well over a year. Defended against all comers. And Fracture might feel that there's unfinished business here, but I mean, I haven't heard official word. I haven't even heard a bell ring, but I'm assuming that either our general manager, Adam Christ, or our referee has allowed to let this match go ahead as a singles match. Oh, just locks on that chin lock. The referee is checking in, so it would seem that this has become an official match. Elbow into the burger box of Victor, pushes him off into the ropes, and oh, locks on a sleeper. Oh, but Valtz beautifully counters that with a back suplex. And what a back suplex. Is it enough though, as he rolls him over, hooks the leg on two exactly. Dragging himself to his feet and just measuring up the face-painted Fracture. Kick to the chest. And I don't think that Fracture the Clown was expecting this sort of a beating. As he just stands above him. Oh, and just drags him up. Manhandles him in to a camel clutch. Doesn't even keep him in that position for long. He just wanted to line him up so he can lay in those beefy shots to the side of the head, which is going to really ring your bell. Another forearm, and Fracture reeling at this point, and can you blame him? He is taking the full onslaught of Victor Von Valtz, the Shoe Pro Champion. Referee just backing him off into the corner. This possibly isn't helping as Rabbit then dives in, and he's choking! He's choking Fracture on the ropes! And Fracture just choking away there. Lil Smash trying to do things right by the rules and trying to get the referee's attention. Oh, and this isn't good. He's going to slingshot him into the bottom turnbuckle face first, and you could break a nose doing that. A clown with a red nose, but not made the way that he'd wanted to. Now Von Valtz just dragging Fracture up, getting to his feet. Look at the confidence in our champion. And now just choking Fracture in the corner. He's got a five count. Referee backs it off. Oh, and Fracture this time. Every time that Von Valtz charges in, he's got an answer for it. Leaps over the top. Can he capitalize? Oh, kick to the head. Puts him into the other turnbuckle, charges in with that back elbow, but oh, wasn't aware that Von Valtz was straight in behind him. Off the ropes, goes for that leg drop, and bounces with it. Such was the ferocity, but only a two. Only just shy of a three, though. Fracture has taken one hell of a beating. Here at Almost Pro, to the point where Victor Von Valtz thinks it was a three. Just laying in with forearms on the champ as he whips him off, reversed. Oh, and taken out with a mighty clothesline. Oh, oh, but a kick to the head. Another one. Now he's, oh, almost a spinning head scissors. Certainly an adapted version from the ground. Never seen that before. Leaps off, goes for the wheelbarrow. Into an arm drag. Japanese arm drag. Springboard and another arm drag. The champion reeling. Comes off the ropes and oh, catches that kick and ducks under that clothesline. What's he going for now? Oh! Like a helter-skelter as he goes for the pin, but Rabbit gets himself involved and lays in with the boots. Well, Fracture the Clown gets the win due to disqualification, but that's not going to help him right now as he's just getting beaten about by our champion. Oh, but he's fighting back against Rabbit. He's really laying it in against his former partner. But that means that he's... Oh, Lil Smash is... Oh! Lil Smash was about to just be destroyed by Victor Von Valtz, but he's been rescued with a Stone Clown Stunner on Rabbit, who's fallen to the outside. Victor Von Valtz. Oh! The Stone Clown Stunner again. Well, definitely your victor in one sense of the world, but he has paid for that victory tonight. We have a skinned and battered Rabbit searching for the safety of the dressing room. And a dominant champion who may walk away without the win, but he certainly has that championship belt and his minion in Rabbit. But the fans don't care too much about that. They want to celebrate with the weird and the wonderful, which is apt on this Halloween Eve here in Chimarine. Imagine they'll be taking themselves out for some trick-or-treating, and they've deserved their sweets after this. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Stallion. This is Almost Pro. Good night out there, whatever you are. Ha, 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 ha.